Okay, when I was in my 20s, I wanted to look like this. I wanted to be about slightly underweight. I wanted to have my ribs showing a little bit, a defined shoulder, a delicate, beautiful, small arm, lean, thin thighs. So this is what I wanted to look like when I was in my 20s. This is a celebrity, Mary-Kate or Ashley Olsen. But this figure is extremely unattainable for me, I've realized as I've gotten older. Now I'm 50, 51, sorry, and I realize I can't look like that. This, look at what I look like. Oh my God, I'm so fat. Okay, look, sorry. Okay, look. This is me. I'm like a big circle on stick with a little head. So what I want to do is go from this. I weigh 5'2½. I weigh 240 pounds, and I want to go to this, what I was before. Now, this is not exactly slim. However, it looks better than this, what I am now. This is me about 5 years ago or 7 years ago. At about 170 pounds, which is still overweight for my height, because I'm 5'2" and the most 2½, sorry. The most I should weigh is like 140 or 145, like within the ideal BMI range. But I just want to get back to this. There's a difference in pounds here. This is 240, this is 170. So I just want to get back to this, and I brought out these photos of myself when I was slimmer, to encourage me to motivate me to get thinner. So as you can see, there's a little dent in here. I actually have a waist here, whereas here it's like, what happened? Okay, what happened? Got too fat. So this is my, as I was saying, this is my Filofax for my weight loss journey. And I just have the measurements of Kim Kardashian here because she has a, although she's thin, she's slim in the ideal weight zone. She's got a more voluptuous build. She's got bigger boobs and a bigger butt. So as you can see, this figure here, this is thin, and this is thin as well. But she's just got more mass on her. So she's not skinny, but she is still very thin. She's still within the, but however, but I, but my body, well, not that I look anything, okay, excuse me, I'm not gorgeous, but like I have a more like voluptuous body. So this is my sort of reference. And also J-Lo is very fit, and she's a little bit shorter and more voluptuous than your typical average fashion model. So to aspire to be as exercising as much as her. And then I have a dashboard by Cloth and Paper Grit. So that's to have grit to hold on to this weight loss journey and to lose weight. So my all-time high was 245. And this photo was taken when I was 240. But as you can see, I've put stickers down to indicate the pounds I've lost, sort of like a jar with jelly beans, like showing how each pound is a circle. And right now I'm at 230. So I've lost 10 pounds because I started kind of using this app at 240, and it's called the Lose It app. And I got it was recommended by a YouTuber called HRH Collection. And she's a very opinionated YouTuber. She can be harsh, but she's so human. I just adore her. Her political views are more conservative, whereas I'm more liberal, but I do enjoy hearing conservatives' point of view. I think there needs to be a balance of viewpoints, and I always enjoy hearing other people's opinions. So that's that. So the Lose It app. Okay, and on the Lose It app, you had a choice of you put into the Lose It app your weight and your height, and then it gives you a plan, a calorie plan. So I could have eaten 2,100 calories per day, or 1,800, or 1,600 approximately, or 1,400. Now, 1,400 will get you to the lowest the quickest, but I know for me, if it's too low, I like to eat, and if I'm too restricted, I'm just gonna gain the weight all back again. So I picked the 16, excuse me, please. I picked the 1,600 calories approximately because that's the most gentle way to lose weight, because like that's reasonable. And you know what? I love it because it's working. This app is working. It's totally free. I didn't pay for a premium subscription. It's totally free. You don't have to do any exercise. That's the glory of it. As long as you're eating that amount of calories for your height and weight, you will still lose weight. Of course, it's good to exercise to tone up, and it's good for your heart and lungs to exercise. So that's good too, of course. But for now, for people like when you're this fat and you're this obese, it's not realistic that you're gonna start running marathons, or even just getting up and going for a walk is difficult for me. So that's what I liked about the Lose It app, because you don't have to exercise. You just eat your 1,600 calories a day and the weight flies off. So I'm really happy about that. And I encourage you, if you have a few pounds to lose, or maybe you're like me, maybe you're a bit obese and you really want to get healthy for your kids or your husband or your partner. So the Lose It app, I recommend it. And then I have my measurements. These dividers I had customized. I bought them on Cessavie.com, or Cessavie. I'm not sure what her. Hold on a second. Okay, so yes, so these are my measurements that I took today. So my weight is 230.4. My neck is 14.5 inches. My biceps are 15 inches. And I just use like a regular tape measure like this, like a dressmaker's tape measure. And okay, so my biceps are 15. My chest is 40 inches around the rib cage, and I'm a triple D. My waist is 48. My hips are 50 inches. My forearms are 10.5 inches. And my upper thigh is 30 inches. So, another thing that it could measure that's not listed here is the calf. Usually, I like to measure the calf. I believe my calf is about 16 inches. So, those are the measurements. And then I just have some motivational dashboards from Cloth and Paper. The harder I work, the luckier I get, which is by Samuel Goldwyn. I think he was the chairman of Fox or MGM Studios or something. So and then just some blank paper, just some extra paper, and I also cut holes. I cut slits where the holes are, so it's easy to rip in and out. Then I have diet, and I wrote dreams don't work unless you do, which I just love this saying because it puts your dreams within reach. You know, just as long as you do your work, you can achieve your dreams. You just have to have your goal, plan, and do the actual practice of it, like actually work on it. Okay, so now this is Pascal's diet. Now, Pascal, I tried Jenny Craig. It didn't work for me. It might work for you. But while I was doing Jenny Craig, Pascal told me, you know what, Christina, you don't have to buy the Jenny Craig food. Just follow this diet. So for breakfast, it's one slice of toast, 1 teaspoon of margarine, 1 tablespoon of peanut butter or an egg, and one fruit. So, as you can see, the breakfast is quite small. And then for lunch, you can have 2 pieces of whole wheat bread. It's important to eat whole grain so that you get the nutrients, because white bread is not healthy for you. It's a refined grain. And so he suggested you could have 3 slices of deli meat, or you could have 1 tablespoon of peanut butter and a tablespoon of jam, Or you could have half a can of tuna with a bit of mayo. I like to use Miracle Whip because Miracle Whip, it has a nice sweet flavor. And of course I use the light. Supper, 4 ounces of lean protein, 1 tablespoon of salad dressing. And in the salad, it's lettuce, tomato, and cucumber. And then as well with supper, 2 cups of cooked vegetable. So it could be any type of vegetable that's not starchy. And half a cup of starch, meaning like potatoes or rice or pasta, whatever you prefer. I'm not currently following this. I just eat whatever I want, but I just follow the Lose It app and I'm losing weight. And then this was another diet I did a few years ago, but it was too restrictive. It's only 1,205 calories, but you do lose weight on it really quickly. But I just wanted to do something slower and more sustainable this time. And this is the diet the nutritionist gave me. I went to see a nutritionist, and this is about 1,400 calories per day. But even this was too restrictive. Like, as you can see, there's no ice cream or desserts listed here. It's all like toast, yogurt, oatmeal, vegetable soup, nuts, peanut butter, chicken, egg, tofu. Hello, we need our desserts. So that's why I like the Lose It app. And then for exercise, I put resilience. I'm gonna get into exercising once I've lost 20 pounds, because the more you lose, the more you're on a momentum and the more you wanna exercise. Ideally, I should go for a walk every day around the block, but I just don't have time. I'm busy with my MFA and teaching and whatnot. And then we have another cloth and paper dashboard, comme il faut, as it should be. That's French for as it should be. This is just an exercise I wrote down. And then I have my outfits. So in this section, outfits, I've just listed what dresses I have now that fit me now. And then I have the clothes that can fit me when I weigh 192. So right now I'm 230. So this is in 40 pounds from now. And I just have all these really pretty dresses and cycle shorts that I can wear. And then I have the clothes that fit me at 182 pounds when I used to weigh 182 before I put on all my weight. And like a Simon skirt, it's like a size, I think it's a size 10-12. These are just a bunch of clothes that I can wear that motivate me every time I look at it, because I remember how I looked and felt in these clothes. And I remember the weight I was at these clothes. So that was just another motivator. These are just clothes I want to replace. And then I made a list of clothes I want to buy. Okay, that's just a little quote from Karl Lagerfeld. And I thought to myself, you know what? I think I'll buy myself a big present once I reach like a massive goal, like 50 pounds lost. So I thought I would buy a GM Damien Azur agenda. I'd have to get that on eBay because they don't make them anymore at Louis Vuitton. I thought I might get myself an MM Damien Azur agenda. Actually, I already have that. Okay, but maybe a Speedy Bandoulier Louis Vuitton bag when I reach my ultimate goal. Which would be about 164 pounds. And then we have this great quote from Cloth and Paper, "Anything worthwhile requires work." And that was said by Christian Boss or Bosse. Then I just have my business card. I'm an artist. And underneath, I just have a journaling card from Cloth and Paper. So it's just about typography, like the period at an end of a sentence. And you know, it just goes to show you can lose weight at any age. Like, I've gone through menopause and I'm very lucky. I had no symptoms. I don't have any hot flashes or anything like that. And you can still lose weight. Just because you're over 50 and you're going through menopause, you can always, always, always lose weight, you know? So I just want to encourage you that way. And then I just have another quote from Cloth and Paper. And then This is some tape I got from, this is some tape I got from James Burke, who's a YouTuber who does art journaling. He's very talented. I loved his washi tape. And so I just taped the front cover. And then there's a pocket here. I don't have anything in there. Okay, so that's it, guys. So I just wanted to encourage you that you can lose weight. You don't have to exercise. Even if you're extremely obese like me, you can get down to being your former slimmer self. So don't worry about it. And yeah, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to write in the comments. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.